Hey everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is some easy last minute holiday hairstyles, and today's video is sponsored by L'Ange, so I'll be using a few of their products to show you how I would prep my hair for these types of hairstyles. Their products are also up to 70% off, which is a huge savings, so I'll be sure to link to those down below in the description box if you want to check them out. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe below and click the notification bell so you'll be notified whenever I post a new tutorial, and let's get started! Before any hairstyle, I always curl my hair, so to protect my hair from the heat, I'm going to start by spraying it with the L'Ange Rival Heat Shield. This is a great product for helping prevent damage from styling tools, and since it's infused with keratin and chamomile extract, it leaves my hair brushable while also adding shine, which is really nice. I'm using the Sienna Paddle Brush, which is lightweight and cushioned, so it glides right through my hair, detangling any knots and helps distribute the product. So then I'm just going to take 1-inch sections and curl them away from my face, holding each section for about 10 seconds. The curling wand I'm using is the Lasong 5-piece curling wand set from L'Ange. It comes in this convenient case and includes 5 different wands, which makes it really easy to switch between a variety of curls, depending on the look you're trying to achieve. And I went ahead and linked this one down in the description box in case you want to check it out. So for my everyday curls, I usually like to switch between the 25mm and 32mm sizes, and today I'm using the 25mm to create a more defined curl. This wand heats up quickly, which I really love. I like to keep mine set around 300 degrees, but I really love how easy it is to create an effortless everyday curl using this wand. So once all of my hair is curled, I like to just use my fingers to gently comb through them so they're softer. And now that my hair is all prepped, I'm going to show you 3 easy styles that would be great for any holiday parties you have coming up. So for the first style, I'm going to start by dividing off a section of hair on the right side of my head and a similar size section on the left side. I'm just going to bring these 2 sections together at the back of my head and tie them off with a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to take the ends and flip them up and around the elastic band so the 2 sides are more twisted. Then I'm just going to hold on to the elastic with one hand and then gently pull on the edges of the twists to make them appear more full. And then I'm going to hide the elastic band by taking a small section of hair, wrapping it around the elastic band, and then I'm just going to slide a bobby pin underneath to hold it in place. Now I'm just going to create 1 more section, repeating the exact same steps again. So I'm dividing out a section of hair underneath the first on both the right and the left sides. I'm going to tie them together at the back of my head underneath the first elastic. Then I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic band so the 2 sides are twisted. And then I'm going to gently pull on the edges of the twist to make them appear fuller. And then I'm going to wrap a small piece of hair around the elastic and pin it underneath with a bobby pin to hide the elastic band. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to divide out a section of hair above both of my ears to give me an idea of what hair I want to use for this style. So once I see how much hair I need, I'm going to let down the hair on the left side to use later on. So with this hair on the right side, I'm going to pick up a small piece of hair at the back of my head and I'm going to tie it together with the hair on the right side using a small elastic band. This little piece of hair will help anchor the hair in place at the back of my head. So then I'm going to pick up the section from the left side that I had divided out earlier, and I'm going to cross this over the elastic band and then wrap the hair underneath the elastic. And then I'm just going to slide some bobby pins into the hair until it feels nice and secured and won't fall loose. Then I'm just going to go back over the style, pulling on the hair at my crown just to add a little bit of texture to this hairstyle. I love how this hairstyle looks a lot more difficult than it actually is, and that the hairstyle itself helps hide the elastic band. For the third style, I'm going to start by dividing out a section of hair on my left side, and I'm leaving out some hair to frame my face, and you can part your hair wherever you normally prefer. And I'm just going to take this section and twist it upwards and then bring in a new section of hair after each turn on the bottom side. So after a twist, I'm adding in a new piece from along my hairline. Then I'm going to twist the hair upwards and add in another piece and just continue working my way along the left side of my head until it reaches the nape of my neck. And then once I've added in hair from the nape of my neck, I'm going to grab a clip and just clip the twist at the back of my head to use later on. So now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create a second twisted section with the hair on the right side. So another way to create the same style of twist is to pick up a section near the hairline, divide it into two pieces, and I'm going to twist the bottom piece over the top while adding in a new section of hair to the bottom piece after I wrap it. So I'm just going to cross the bottom piece over the top piece, pick up a new section of hair from along my hairline, adding it into the bottom section. Then I'm going to cross that bottom section over the top, creating a twist, and just work my way down along the right side of my head until it reaches the nape of my neck. And then once I've brought in hair from the nape of my neck like before, I'm going to combine all of the hair together and tie it off with a hairband to create a ponytail. And then to hide the hairband like usual, I'm going to take a section of hair from the ponytail, wrap it around the hairband, and pin it underneath with a bobby pin. And there you have it. I love how easy and elegant this last hairstyle looks.
So that wraps up today's tutorial. A big thank you to Longe for sponsoring today's video. Be sure to check out some of their items. They're up to 70% off, and I'll leave a link down below in the description box. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and be sure to click the notification bell so you'll be notified whenever I post a new tutorial. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.